today I had the great fortune to be talking to Tawara Goode, who is the UCEDD director here at Georgetown University, and she's a board member at AUCD. And the first question is, what is culture?
What is culture? So as we think about culture, a lot of people confuse culture with race and ethnicity. So culture is related, but it's different. We teach children our culture as soon as they're born. We teach them what it means to be a member of the family. We teach them the language. We teach them gender roles. We teach them all about culture. And so what's important to know about culture is that culture is learned. Culture is also how we think about and how we act in the world. It really shapes how we interact with others. Culture really influences how we communicate, our body language, like I'm using my hands a lot now, our facial expressions. I'm smiling because I'm really, really happy that you're here with us today. Culture influences the food that we eat. It influences how we dress, and it really influences the roles that we have in our family. So culture is all of these things.
We didn't talk about disability, so what does culturally and disability?
All right, so that's also very important, and I'm glad that you raised it. The culture really influences our beliefs about disability and ability, so that those are things that would be within any given culture. Culture influences how we think about self-advocacy. It influences our ideas about self-determination and also independence, because that's what we learned from people around us. And culture really influences how you make decisions, who helps you make decisions about day-to-day life.
What does culturally diverse?
I think that culturally diverse means many different things to different people. So I'll share with you how we think about it here at the Georgetown UCEDD. Cultural diversity means that people have a range of things that make them that person. So we would look at someone's age, we would look at someone's race or ethnicity. In some communities, we would look at their tribal affiliation, we would look at their gender, we would look at their sexual orientation, we would look at their religious beliefs. So many, many things contribute to our ideas about cultural diversity. It makes how we distinguish one group from another, and it includes many, many factors, probably too many to name in our short time with this interview.
We haven't talked about healthcare. How does healthcare relate to culturally diverse?
That's a really great question. And we know that this is so important, that culture impacts healthcare and actually the health and well-being of people in many ways. So when I think about illness or what it means to be ill or what it means to be healthy or what it means to have a disability, I'm influenced by my culture. And so that it's really important for healthcare providers to understand their patients, understand what their patients believe about their health, about what caused their illness, about what things will make them well. It's important for healthcare providers to understand disability and what disability means. They need to be able to communicate with anyone who comes in the door. So if that's a person with a disability, if it's a person with hearing loss, that healthcare providers need to understand and address the cultural diversity that we see in all people.